Okay, we start here to talk about Agatha, and especially about Agatha with inclusion. In this chapter, we explain about Moss Agatha. First, a classification of Agatha. The term Agatha is, by definition, banded chalcedony. So this is the only stuff that can be strictly defined agate. But usually people refer to agate as all chalcedony that can be nodular or in vein that have other inclusions inside and not forcedly banded. So moss agate, plume agate, dendritic and sagenitic are chalcedony, not banded, but chalcedony with inclusion that are usually called agate. So the inclusion can be crystalline or non-crystalline. The crystalline inclusion are some kind of crystals, usually zeolite, because are the first formed minerals in basaltic volcanic rock, but also aragonite, anhydrite, and other minerals of low temperature that are present in the cavity before the chalcedony arrive. So when arrive, chalcedony fill all the cavity and the crystal are trapped inside. Some other inclusions are non-crystalline, and there are some that are syngenetic, so they are formed at the same time of the chalcedony, and these are moss or plume, depending on the shape of the inclusion. And another group of agate inclusion is dendritic, but dendritic usually are a later phenomenon, so is a mineral, the manganese, that enter in some crack of the agate. But there is a group of dendritic agate that are also syngenetic. We will see later. So in this chapter we will talk about moss agate. Moss agate are hydrated minerals that form on the wall of the cavity and grow inward from the wall toward the center of the cavity. And they grow inside the chalcedony. So they grow when chalcedony was soft. The growth of moss is as filament, and they start from a germ, a crystalline germ, that is at the host rock, so probably there is a kind of crystals that put in reaction some metallic ion, and the reaction occur and start to crystallize this mineral. But because the colloidal solution is very dense, is impossible for the germ to crystallize, and it forms a polymer and grow as a filament. Okay. The distribution inside the nodule of the moss depend on the ability of remove the moss when they are just formed. For example, if we start to form moss all around in the wall cavity, and then we remove by detachment on the filament fall at the base, so they stop the possibility to grow more filament from the base. So it's clear that filament grow only from the upper part. And from the upper part, the best place for remove is the center, because from the side it's more difficult that the gravity can fall down the material, and there is less solution to be in reaction. So this is the reason then when the filament grow from the top of the cavity, the fall mound that form at the base is shaped like this. So the more abundant moss are folded in the center area. So basically, in general term, most of the moss grow in this area of the cavity and fall at the base, making a mound. So the colloidal solution is so dense that the filament can float, is just freezed inside, can stay in the middle until the chalcedony be hardened. But if there is a phase of dilution, so some water arrive, the colloidal solution become more diluted, and the filament of moss can be driven by gravity and fall down. So the presence of the mound at the base indicate that there was a phase of dilution. In the contrary, if all the moss are suspended, are floating in the chalcedony, so this dilution never arrive. Okay, the moss agate take its name from green variety. This is the more popular, usually from India in ancient time. There was used for jewelry and for make decoration object. But there is a moss of almost every color. There are red, yellow, pink, white, brown, black, etc. So not only green are moss, all the color are considered moss. And what mineral, what are made that inclusion? So most are microcrystalline or amorphous minerals, and are mineral of low temperature. So we have different shape of moss that are made of different minerals. A very common mineral making moss or plume, the inclusion in agate, is opal, or a kind of jasper. So we can see the appearance is like opal, with some crack. When you polish, this take a very good polish, but is little bit less hard than chalcedony. Another group of minerals is probably a group of chlorite minerals, and are with structure, vermicular structure. And vermicular structure are like mica, or many lamella all together. And they make like a verm. So this is typical structure of chlorite group minerals. But also other structure is not vermicular, like dendritic or tree-shaped, but also the appearance is lamellar. So tiny sheet-like crystals. In most of these cases, when we try to analyze, we find only chalcedony, because most of the moss are replaced by chalcedony, so it's quite difficult to say exactly what mineral was at the moment of crystallization. Another mineral composing inclusion are iron oxide and manganese oxide. Manganese oxide is clearly metallic and very evident. They form a very big plume, and they take a very good polish. At the contrary, iron oxide is like ochre. They form very nice structure with very beautiful color, but in most case this ochre color is powdery, so is quite bad for polishing. And another mineral that is often included in agate, is marcasite. So all this mineral more or less hypothesizes, because when there is not analysis, like in this case we're guessing a little bit about the mineralogy of these minerals, but They are all mineral of low temperature and can crystallize or form, if they are amorphous, inside the chalcedony, inside the colloidal solution. The vermicular crystallization is a typical crystallization of chlorite group minerals. We see here a same image of kaolinite, and this is chlorite inside quartz. And this, the appearance is more crystalline than usually are the filament in the agate. So they probably form in this way, but after a time they are replaced, so they leave only the shape of the filament, and they lose the crystallization, vermicular crystallization. So this is another example of cocheite, another mineral of chlorite group. So all this kind of structure that in this case are in quartz or in books are present inside the chalcedony. This here we can see the lodo quartz, where kaolinite and chlorite are very nice formed inside, and they are very crystalline with the clear sheet like crystals. But very similar structure is found also inside the agate, that is the same composition of quartz but less crystalline, more amorphous, and the shape is very similar, is vermicular. But in this case we cannot now realize the real sheet phyllosilicate crystal, and we see only the vermicular. So these two cases are almost the same situation, but here is more amorphous or cryptocrystalline, and this is a truly crystalline case. Okay, most grow from the wall of the cavity, as we see. So they grow from the cavity wall for reaction with the host rock, and when there is dilution can fall down. This case is called a pendant, and this is the moment when the filament is almost detached from the roof and fall down at the base. So this is freezed in this situation. This is another case where the filament is on another plane, but we can see all the chalcedony around the filament that make like a stalactite here. So this reaction between the gel, the silica gel, and the ion, metallic ion that are inside with host rock, are depending on the kind of the host rock. So these reactions are very abundant in intermediate tuff and lavas, where more abundant moss are found, but are totally absent in agate found in carbonatic rocks, because carbonaceous rock are very poor in metallic element, so there is no reaction between the silica gel and the host rock. In basalt, that are that is a rock very rich in iron, but there is usually the formation of a celadonite skin. That is a thin green film that coated the cavity very early after this solidification and the cooling of the lava flow. So this film that coated the cavity make more difficult the reaction between the gel silica with the cavity. So the moss are more stiff than the colloidal solution where they float, and in this is proved because in many cases the solution can be drained, so we can have a formation like this coral chalcedony that clearly the filament of moss are formed inside the gel, but after its solidification the gel disappear, and this is a case where the gel remain and solidify altogether, but this is the case where the gel is gone. This means that the solidification of the agate start from the filament, because the polymerization and crystallization of the minerals give a more hard appearance. So it is a true crystallization, and this is stiff, and this is a phase when it's possible that some other mineral like sagenite grow on the top of the chalcedony, and this what happened here, that some ball of some kind of zeolite are grow in this situation, but then again the solution enter inside the field of the porosity. Okay, the moss can be filamentous and more or less bifurcated. In this case filamentous are very long with shape of hair, and they are not bifurcated. Here they are more bifurcated, here more bifurcated, and in some cases they are short and big, and the interior can be massive, but sometimes can be empty and or also with some dusting. So it's clear that the filament is made of one mineral, but around the filament there is a kind of chalcedony more hardened. So the filament, like in this two picture, can be very long and very rarely bifurcated, or very short and frequently forked. So this is two extreme situation. In both cases, when the moss accumulate at the base, the chalcedony can be squeezed off and leave just moss, and the chalcedony was gone. Probably this was on the top of the agate, so the chalcedony is gone, and what remains is a material completely done by moss that have a look of a jasper, but is an agate, but completely made by moss. The very common situation is that the filament hang from the roof of the cavity and go toward the base, and in many cases this situation is freezed. So in these two samples at the base there is almost nothing, so the filament are going falling slowly, but never reach the base. This is because the the gel was really very dense. This is another situation when where the filament fall down, make this kind of situation with all the filament hanging from the roof, and there is also moss in different shape. So we can have from vermicular situation to cotton ball shaped or more strange shape masses of moss, and in this case is often the interior of the moss do not take good polish, so they are made of a mixture of minerals that are not completely silicated. So this is a vermicular moss in an agate. This is another sample with completely vermicular moss inside. And this is another case where a dilution have provoked that all the moss fall down. So in this case we see that there is nothing at the roof, so all the filament have fallen at the base and are accumulated at the base. So we see the situation that the inferior half of the nodule is filled of moss and the superior half is banded. This is a very common situation. This, for example, is some laguna. This is an agoneva, but all from the same area in Mexico. And the typical situation is that the half inferior part of the nodule is filled by moss that are fallen from the roof, and the upper half is banded agate. In this case, all the the filament have fallen down. We see the perfect mound at the base of the cavity, and we see yet some moss pending from the roof, but most have been subtracted from the wall of the cavity and is sedimented at the base. So this is a typical case of more or less complete dilution of the cavity. And if the the falling of moss is very important, we can accumulate moss at the base, and we can make a real stratification of different moss of different color. And we can see that near the base all the chalcedony have been squeezed off, and no chalcedony here, so only moss, but in the upper part where the load is less, there is more porous with some area with chalcedony, and the stratification is less flat, is more undulated. So this flatness is due by the load of the upper moss that fall down. And also the moss can be structured. We see clusters like this, but also there is a structure like a festoon. So the moss grow from part of the wall of the cavity, and then grow, and it become longer than the cavity, and detach and make a festoon. And the festoon can detach, move, and fall down as is, and we can find piece of festoon at the base of the nodule. This is, for example, a nodule where most of the moss grow from this area, and then they are detaching, leaving some piece of festoon like this. This is also another example where there is a two group of festoon. One is here, the upper part, and the other is here. And we see that in this portion there is a broken moss that fall down and arrive here. So we can see that this portion of the festoon is broken, and the piece is flipped and fall down here. So this is the situation. The piece is here, and we can see it's moving. So this means that the festoon are fragile. So they are not plastic. They are hard and can be broken. This means that there has been a desiccation phase in the cavity, and this can the desiccation can break the moss, and for this reason, the piece of moss have fallen down.